Baseball on tap from Fenway Park in Boston. It'll be the Blue Jays and the Red Sox coming up next. Afternoon baseball for you now on the show, coming your way from venerable Fenway Park here in Boston. Today, game two of this four-game set between the Blue Jays and the Boston Red Sox. Welcome in, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian here to bring you this early season matchup. Alongside me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, ought to be a decent pitching matchup here this afternoon.
Yeah, and you've got a couple of guys here that aren't afraid to challenge you at the plate. They're not afraid to let you put the ball in play and let their fielders make the plays behind them. That should make for a pretty good matchup.
More from the guys moving forward this afternoon, but first, let's bring in a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Toronto Blue Jays, as their order will read like this. They'll match up against the American League's Cy Young Award winner for 2012, the hard-throwing left-hander David Price. Troy Tulowitzki makes his way to the plate, and we are ready for some daytime baseball.
Troy Tulowitzki.
First pitch of the ball game is swung on and missed, and that's how we'll get things started this afternoon. Now, these Red Sox entering play here this afternoon, EK. It was another loss for them last time out, and that makes them 2-8 over their last 10 games.
I just think they were sort of flat in the opener. They didn't play with a whole lot of inspiration, and that was reflected in the final score.
And they take him out of the zone here, and he obliges. Not the greatest of swings there for the first out. Here's a look now at the defensive alignment they'll have to contend with.
Kevin Pillar.
Fouled off into the seats behind first. Price ready with the 0-1. Comes back with a good changeup there, and it's quickly 0-2.
Yeah, it's so hard to stay back against a guy like this. Unless you guess right, that thing's just so slow that it's almost impossible to keep from getting out on your front foot.
Good job of holding up on the low ball there, and it's 1-2. Altogether, a fine afternoon for baseball. 66 degrees, the game time temperature. Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. Four pitches. Fast, slow, fast, slow. EK, you thinking fastball here?
It seems to fit the pattern, but you better not get too predictable out there. Guys will catch on quick.
Now a ball hit high down the left field line, but back in amongst the spectators, foul. Another try at 2-2. And here's a drive sent out to deep left center field. Is it high enough to get over the monster? It is gone, a home run. So a solo shot here to left center field. Eighth home run on the season for him. As the Jays get the game's first tally, it's 1-0.
Yeah, it's one thing to hit one right down the line here at Fenway, but when you can get one over that wall out there, you know you've hit one. I mean, there ain't a yard in the land that would have held that baby.
Josh Donaldson will get his first opportunity here, currently leading the league in two of the three Triple Crown categories.
Thank you.
Hit hard on the ground to short. Throw over to Ortiz. Gets him two down.
Batting fourth, the right fielder number 19,
Jose Bautista, will get his first opportunity here. Took an 0 for 4 in the victory last night. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1. And the pitch. Swing and a ball hit on the ground. But the throw bounces on him at first, and the inning's going to continue.
Well, let me tell you, when you're on a losing streak, this is an out. But when you're on a winning streak, man, these are the little breaks that just seem to always go your way. He's got himself an infield single.
Standing in now, Edwin Encarnacion. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. He comes in with that average down in the 240s. Three homers and five driven in. A runner on first with two away. Now a ball lined toward the gap in left center. And he is going to reach. It's a base hit.
Yeah, not exactly the time to raise the warning flags just yet, but it's not often you'll see him give up three hits in the first inning. It's easy to sit here and say, maybe he doesn't have his best stuff, but it wouldn't surprise me at all to see him run off a string of eight in a row either.
Chris Colabello will get his first shot here. As you can see, he currently leads the junior circuit in hitting. Now the first pitch here from Price. Fastball in there for a called strike.
Now here's a spot with a run home already. That looks nice on the scoreboard. But if you could put up a two or even a three spot here in the first, that could really go a long way against a guy like this.
And he chased one there as this is bounced to short. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Jay's off to a good start thanks to the solo shot. On to the bottom of the first from Fenway. It's now 1-0 Toronto. Starting lineup for the Red Sox looks like this. Behind him defensively, the Blue Jays take the field like so. Mookie Betts comes to the plate to lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Right fielder, Mookie Betts.
And this is going to be a foul ball. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. And, Eric, the Blue Jays, as they enter play here this afternoon, they come in unbeaten and playing well here in the early going.
But they are in for a tough test here this afternoon as they are facing one of the best pitchers around. But the way they've been playing lately, I don't think they're going to be too fazed by it.
Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
And obviously, any time you can strike this guy up, you'll take it. I mean, he runs like a greyhound. So even routine grounders can sometimes be turned into base hits. Not when you come making contact, though.
In now, Xander Bogaerts. Swing and a soft liner back up the middle. And that finds its way into center for a one-out base hit.
Well, the good ones make it look easy, don't they? I mean, if you're hitting 230, this ball doesn't drop for a hit. No way. But he'll tell you, that's just the way I had it planned.
David Ortiz stands in as he can't connect here. 0-1. He's ready now. The pitch. 0-2 now as a curveball drops in there for a strike. First curveball of the day for him, and likely not the last.
No, he's got a good one. There's no doubt about that. He'll start it on the hip versus righties, and he'll backdoor it to lefties. Two different locations, but equally effective.
And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Well, that's a good confidence builder with a runner on base here in the first. This is definitely the man to worry about in this lineup. There's little question about that, so he'll be fired up about that one.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. And this is down at knee level as it's chopped foul at home plate. And he missed with it. It's 1-2.
Could be that that high fastball there was just a setup pitch. Now you've kind of established that high sight level.
Threw it right past him. A swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Red Sox leave one. They still trail 1-0. Russell Martin will stand in, getting the start here despite being out of the lineup last night.
Russell Martin.
The pitch. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Now the pitch. And there's a swing and a miss by Martin as he falls behind now, 0-2.
Wow, what a good time to take something off of that pitch. And they had him fooled pretty good on that one.
Hammered the other way to deep right field. And that is into the visitor's bullpen, a home run. A solo shot for Russell Martin as the Blue Jays take a 2-0 advantage.
What a good effort out there in right field. Remember, we saw Torrey Hunter have some problems with that wall in the postseason, but this ball's far enough into the bullpen that he had no shot at pulling this thing in.
Stepping in now, Darwin Barney. As he swings at the first pitch and lifts a fly ball out to left field. There to take it is Castillo when he makes the play for the first out. Michael Saunders will stand in now. He homered in the ball game last night. Now a ground ball towards the hole. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now. Back to the top of the order now. And danger now is standing in as the fine shortstop, Troy Tulowitzki. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. And Tulowitzki's got himself a base hit.
Boy, when you stroll to the plate with an 11-game hitting streak and then you bang out another base hit and take it to 12, you got a little swagger about you.
Into the box now, Kevin Pillar. Ball hit pretty well out toward left center. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. So a two-run shot to left center, his second of the game, as the Blue Jays have opened it up further now, 4-0.
Well, it seems to me like we've seen this before. His second home run of the ball game. And it would seem to me that he hit that one harder than he did the last one. So he's definitely locked in.
Standing in now, Josh Donaldson. Swung on and popped high in the air out toward short right field. Waiting for it now is Pedroia. And he will make the catch, so that'll do it. So two home runs in the inning lead to 3 runs on the scoreboard. Pablo Sandoval will stand in, and he wasn't alone in wearing the collar in last night's ball game, in which the team could muster all of 1 run. And now the first pitch of the inning is sent in the air out to straightaway center. Pilar is there now to make the play, and on one pitch, Sandoval is retired.
Second baseman, Dustin Pedroia.
So the base is empty here with one away, and that'll bring up the former MVP second baseman, Dustin Pedroia. And now the second pitch of the inning is in the air to right. There to take it is Bautista, and he's got it for out number 2.
Batting 7th, center fielder, Jackie Bradley.
Jackie Bradley Jr. gets his first chance here, looking to make something happen with 2 gone in the bottom of the 2nd. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1.
Boy, if he makes contact there and makes an out, that's a 3-pitch inning. I think I would have had him looked at least 0-2. One.
And Bradley swings and misses at that offering, and he's deep in the hole, 0-2. Just a touch outside, 1-2.
Such a tough pitch to lay off there. The two-seamer working away with 2 strikes, but he lets it go. Maybe just because he knew he couldn't hit it.
Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. We'll see the dangerous Jose Bautista when we come back. It's the Blue Jays 4 and the Red Sox nothing. And here is Jose Bautista now. He'll be the one to lead it off against David Price here in the inning. Now the first pitch here from Price. Swing and a line drive to center field. And a base hit now, as that's how the 3rd inning gets underway.
Yeah, more trouble here to start the 3rd inning. And trouble's been his middle name so far. You see the line. That's through just 2 innings of work now. And the way things are going, he may not be sticking around a whole lot longer.
Edwin Encarnacion is the batter. Got a base hit in his first trip. From the belt, the pitch. A changeup floats outside here for ball 1.
And even though he's given up his share of hits so far, he still hasn't walked anybody, so at least he's got that going for him.
Nobody out, runner on first. And that's in there, base hit.
Another example here. This is right over the middle of the plate. It's elevated a bit. Just a complete miss in location, and they jump on him again.
And some action now in the Boston bullpen as a right-hander's up and throwing. Into the box, Chris Colabello. Now a swing, and he pops him up. Right up the chute. This may be tough behind the plate. And he's retired one away. Russell Martin stands in again. He got a hold of one and went yard in his first plate appearance. Comes set. Now the pitch. Now a little tapper here up the first baseline. The throw pulls him off the bag.
Well, these guys have not got off to a good start. It's no surprise that their defense has been a big factor why. Going to need to figure this out soon because this is another play that needs to be made.
Darwin Barney set the plate now as he looks at strike one. It's going to take a lot of guile to work out of this one.
Well, he's got plenty in reserve. This would need to be a magic act, no doubt.
Price ready with the 0-1. In the dirt and block behind the plate. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. Big breaking ball and a beauty that time. 1-2.
Now with two strikes, he can put the ground ball on the back burner and really go after the strikeout here.
Price is 1-2, and he swings on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate.
Come on, let's get the ground ball.
And oh man, that caught him pretty good there as it ricochets toward the third baseline. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile the runner is in to score.
Well, you know all the infielders are trying to try and knock a ball down in that RBI situation. But here on the mound, I don't think he had any choice. This one comes back at him and gets him flush. By the time they all scramble around to find the ball, they have no chance of preventing that run from scoring.
Michael Saunders will stand in another dangerous spot here in the inning as this ball game is hanging on the precipice of getting out of hand.
Yeah, I think you have to get this guy if you're going to have any chance of sticking around. Even a single here might put this one out of reach.
I had him lunging at that one out of the zone, and that's strike one.
You can bet they'd love to have him get out of this without having to call him that bullpen just yet.
Hit on the ground towards first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Blue Jays forced to settle for just the one. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. It's the Blue Jays 5 and the Red Sox nothing. Ruzne Castillo digs into the box in the bottom of inning number three.
Left fielder.
Now a fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one. And a bouncing ball foul. And this is fouled back and out of play. And this is going to be a foul ball. And this is swung on and missed, though the ball did hit the ground, so he'll need to go to first. Throw on to first is in time to get him, so that'll go down as a strikeout and a 2-3 putout for out number one.
Boy, that's a really nice play there behind the plate. He doesn't panic. He takes his time and makes the good throw on to first, So score that a strikeout with a 2-3 putout for good measure.
Stepping in now, Blake Swihart. And here's a first pitch curveball that bounces on him there. It's ball one. He'll enter play here with that average down in the low 200s. No home runs just yet, and with just the lone RBI. Look out, 2-0 now.
Can't imagine guys like that too much.
Yeah, not too much indeed. You start getting into the danger area when it's up and in that high.
Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Throw is not going to be in time to get him, and somehow he's going to wind up with an infield single. And hold on a minute now. It looks like we may see that last call challenged here. The call on the field was safe, but it was definitely a bang-bang play and tough for us to tell at full speed.
Yeah, Matt, definitely a close play right there as we're going to get another look at it right here. Boy, that's just so tough to tell for sure from that replay. And we're going to have to see what the word from the dugout is. Remember, the ruling on the field is safe.
And that's a thumbs up from the bench, so they will challenge the call on the field. So the umpires on replay duty in Manhattan will now review the play from all available angles in order to make the final decision.
All right, so here's one final look at it. Now remember, there has to be indisputable video evidence in order to overturn the call. Now the ruling on the field is safe, and it probably could go either way, but I don't think there's enough right here to overturn this call and call him out.
And we'll get our answer here as it appears the umpires have made their decision and the headset comes off. And the runner is safe at first as originally called, so they will lose the ability to challenge for the remainder of the game. Mookie Betts will stand in here. He was set down on strikes to start the home first. Off the plate and low here, ball one. The early hit total, about what you'd expect in a score line such as this. Now he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. Colabello is over now, and he's got it for out number two.
The shortstop, number two,
Xander Bogaerts will dig in. He singled his first time around. Swing and a bouncing ball toward the hole. Throw on to second for the force, and the side is retired. After the break, don't go away. Troy Tulowitzki will start things off. It's the Blue Jays 5 and the Red Sox nothing. And here is Troy Tulowitzki. He'll lead things off as they look to perhaps build on an already sizable lead. Now a ball hit to center field and deep. Back goes the center fielder way back, and that ball is gone. A solo home run off the bat of Troy Tulowitzki, number 197 in his career. As they pile on, it's now 6-0.
He has proven to be a real nuisance in the first two games of this series. A home run in last night's ball game, and now another one here.
Here comes Sox manager John Farrell on his way out to the mound. And that's going to be all this afternoon for David Price. So he'll exit here this afternoon to a smattering of boos after what can be described as really a subpar performance.
Your attention,
Joe
please.
Kelly is going to come on and make an appearance here, though I suspect even he couldn't have predicted he'd be taking over in just the fourth inning. In now, Kevin Pillar.
Kevin Pillar.
as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. Bases are empty here, nobody out.
Let's go, Red Sox!
Now a ball hit in the air to left center. There to take it is Castillo, and he makes the play for the first out. Josh Donaldson will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. Oh, had him chopping at that one. It's nothing and one.
And that's right where you want to be with your specialty pitches. If you can start them knee high and let them dip out of the strike zone, you'll have a lot of success with locations like that one.
Ah, not able to hold on there as he swings through a pitch in the dirt, and it doesn't look good for him now, down 0-2.
One thing you've got to be aware of as a hitter is he's going to give you a bit of a variety up there. He's got five pitches, and he's going to use all of them.
And he'll take the fastball here inside off the plate. It's 1-2. The ball flying around the yard in this one, as you see so far there. And he's got himself a base hit.
You know, a lot of times with a sinker baller, the thought is that you've got to get out there and hit the ball before it sinks. So that means if you're a right-handed hitter, you got to jump out there and pull it. And that's exactly what he did.
Jose Bautista steps in with one in, one out, and one on here in the inning. From the belt, kicks and deals. Foul back. He's ready. Now the pitch. Oh, has him looking silly here. It's 0-2.
Boy, what a great pitch right there. Against a power hitter, looking to pull the ball. He had no legs behind him on that swing whatsoever.
Come set. Now the pitch. Oh, and a good curveball that time as it's taken for a called strike three, and there are two away. Edwin Encarnacion steps in, got a base hit in his last at-bat. Pause, now the pitch. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. Six runs, 10 hits, and no errors in the game for Toronto. Swing and a high chopper to third. On to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Jays add one more on the solo home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's the Blue Jays 6 and the Red Sox nothing. David Ortiz will come forward now to start the inning, and with his guys down 6 in the early going, they're going to need to put something together here or risk being blown out.
Yeah, and I think the big thing here is you've got to come up with something, even if it's just one run. You got to let those guys over there know that you haven't given up and that you're going to fight them until the last out.
Here we go.
Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. Throw on to first by Tulowitzki is in time for out number one.
Designated hitter, Travis Shaw.
Travis Shaw is into the box. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Grounded foul off to the left near Brian Butterfield in the third base coaching box. Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1. One and two. Well, that pitch isn't going to light up the radar gun, but it's been effective.
Well, it doesn't have to. If you get that good movement and put it in the right spot, it's plenty good enough to do the job.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
And I'll tell you what, he's throwing with a lot of confidence right now. And he's also taking some chances with location, but you know, he's thinking he's bulletproof out there, and so far he has been.
Pablo Sandoval is at the plate now, flied out in his first at-bat. Here's the pitch. A fastball that gets the inside corner, strike one. Oh, and that is right down the middle for strike two.
Boy, he might be pressing his luck a little now. That's two straight pitches right down the middle.
Now here's the pitch. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Red Sox go down 1-2-3. They won't make a dent in a 6-0 deficit. Chris Colabello will stand in for the third time now, still without a hit, so that streak could be in a bit of jeopardy.
And I think that's in the back of his mind, but it's not something he's really focused on. He just wants to get up there and put a good swing on the ball.
Now here's the pitch. Up and away to start the inning. It's 1-0. And not the greatest approach there as he offers it a pitch in the dirt, and it's even at 1-1. Here's a ball hit pretty well and carrying to deep right. And the leadoff man gone now to start the fifth. So the leadoff man's retired now for Russell Martin. And now a pitch on the way. Now a swing and a ground ball, but this is foul for the first strike.
Get out of here, Blue Jay.
And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. Now this is swung on, and here's another fly ball out to right field. Betts is there, two down.
Now batting, second baseman, Darwin Barney.
Darwin Barney will try it again, 0 for 2 with a fly out and a ground ball thus far. Here it comes.
Here we go, Red Sox.
Hey now.
No, that missed.
Sometimes if you let that changeup go too soon, it'll take off on you. He's lucky that didn't hit him.
Come on, Red Sox.
And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate.
Start.
Ball and two strikes, the count now with the bases empty and two away.
This fastball is looking pretty lively right now.
All right. Stretch out here.
Chopper foul. Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats in left. Speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. Blue Jays go down in order. They lead it 6-0. Dustin Pedroia will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
Out of play off to the right. It's 1-1. The pitch. And the third baseman will have a look at it, but this is back into the seats. To two balls and two strikes now.
And at least he's taken a few pitches here. Well, that's more than the rest of these guys can say.
And a swing by Pedroia as this one's on the ground out to short. Throw on to first in time, one away.
Number 25, center fielder.
Jackie Bradley Jr. comes to the plate looking to put the ball in play. He went down on strikes last time.
Yeah.
Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one.
Real good lateral movement on that two-seam fastball. That pitch is money for him when it's moving like that, so just keep on throwing it.
And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
Yeah, and if you've got him to look at the first pitch up there, why not throw it again? Also letter high. That puts him in a quick 0-2 hole.
Inside, as that perhaps will back him off a bit. 1-2.
Tough pitch to lay off there with two strikes. I'm not sure if that was a good take or whether he just got fooled on a changeup and couldn't pull the trigger.
Now here it comes. And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him.
Well, this is a stroll he's taken 5 times in this series now. That slow walk back to the dugout after getting punched out. After a while, these things, they start to wear on you. You've got to try to keep the mindset that every at-bat's a new opportunity, but most of the time, that's easier said than done.
Oh, and he breaks out the hook here. Good for strike two.
Boy, he is putting on a clinic out there right now. These guys don't know what to look for.
Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
1-2.
Now the pitch.
Here we go.
And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Red Sox. They still find themselves down 6-0. Michael Saunders will stand in, one of the few guys not to join the hit parade so far. Pitch on the way. Pretty well hit, deep down the line and right, but that's back into the seats, foul. Swing and a high pop-up back onto the outfield grass now. And the sixth inning opens with a flyout, one away. One out now in the Toronto sixth inning. And danger now is standing in as the fine shortstop, Troy Tulowitzki. Now the pitch. And a bouncing ball, foul. 6 runs, 10 hits, and no errors in the game for Toronto. And Tulowitzki lifts this ball down the left field line, but it'll wind up hooking foul back up into the seats. Now here's the pitch. Got him looking with the fastball as that had some two-seam movement to it. Two gone.
And if you want to see a guy get blown away at the plate, this is just one finger down 3 times in a row. He was just overmatched there.
Kevin Pillar will stand in again as we flash you back to the early stages of this ball game. There were fans still finding their seats as he launched his second home run of the game, as he was off to a fast start indeed. Way off balance hack that time, good for the first strike.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one, and that's not the kind of swing we're accustomed to seeing from a guy like him.
Right, especially starting off an at-bat.
Missed low and inside with it, 1-1.
What was that?
Here's the pitch. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Here it comes. And here's a ball hit in the air. And Bogaerts will make the catch for the final out of the inning. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays. But they're on top by a count of 6-0. Blake Swihart will come forward now to start out their half of the sixth, and they've found it rough sailing against this starter so far, as he's yielded just 2 hits through the first 5.
Not too many hard hit balls there either. He's had them off balance all game.
First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike. For that man right there, you need look back only to his last start to see a performance like the one he's shown here so far.
And well on his way to another great outing. And that's what you get when you mix your speeds and throw a lot of strikes.
And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. And he struck him out. So double digits now, 10 strikeouts for him thus far.
Well, not only is that 10 strikeouts now, but I'll tell you what, we've still got a few innings to go here. He keeps throwing the way he is, he can make that number really interesting by the time this one's through.
Mookie Betts will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. Chopper foul. Down and away, ball one.
Well, we've seen this before. Fastballs in, then breaking balls away. That's been his M.O. throughout the first half of this game.
Takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and 2 strikes now. I'll tell you, he's been living on that corner all afternoon.
And you can tell, guys at the plate, they're starting to get frustrated. He just hasn't made many mistakes at all, and when he has, they've been out of the zone.
And this is fouled back and out of play. One out, nobody on.
Come on, let's get a hit.
And a swing and a ball hit foul heading for the seats. So another foul ball here, and it remains 1-2. Now here it comes. Swing, and I believe this one is going to find the seats as well. It does, so quite a battle here as it remains 1-2. This is hit on the ground, but foul. Curveball just about rung him up, but it's to 2-2.
And you know what, guys? This is a big league battle going on right now. Neither guy wanting to back down. No sign of weakness on either side.
Ani finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at bat.
Well, if you're just tuning into this game and you're wondering what's going on so far, well, here's the last 4 guys that have come to the plate. Here they are in order, and he's set down all 4 of those guys, all via the strikeout.
Xander Bogaerts will stand in now with 2 away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Hold the last few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
Curveball looked at here for strike one. Bases are empty here with 2 men out.
And
here's a curveball in for a ball. 1-1.
Let's go. Wait for the pitch.
Fouled back. And the pitch.
Let's go, Sox. Come on,
that's it to short. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? You bet he does. 11 in a row set down, and the inning is over. Red Sox go down 1-2-3. They won't make a dent in a 6-0 deficit. Welcome back to Fenway Park here in the great city of Boston. Seventh inning coming up with the Jays out in front as we give you a look at our game summary to this point. Anthony Varvaro will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Josh Donaldson gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point.
Josh Donaldson.
And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one.
Well, that's a pretty good spot to try and lock him up inside, but you know, he can turn on that location if that's out over the plate.
Donaldson awaiting the 1-0. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Strike him out! Strike him out!
Fouled back. Now here's the pitch. Oh, not cheated on that one. It's 2-2. Now the pitch. Fastball is outside, and it's full now, 3-2. And a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh. It's ball four.
And for as hot as this guy's been recently, this is a no-brainer. Take the bat out of his hands any chance you get.
Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. Pedroia, and he'll have to hold on to it there as the takeout slide had him well off balance.
Well, this is a pretty smart decision here at second base. He's got that clock running in his head, so he knows he's about to take a shot. So at that point, why risk throwing this ball into the dugout or into the 10th row? He just absorbs the hit, and he hangs on to the baseball.
Into the box now, Edwin Encarnacion. And there's a swing and a miss at an off-speed pitch to start him out, nothing in one.
Well, that is such a good pitch. First pitch changeup, when you know a guy's a first pitch fastball guy, just use his aggressiveness against him.
Chop fouled at the plate here, and it's 0-2. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. Just off the end of the bat, it's a foul ball, and he'll stick around. Here he comes again, 1-2. And him out. Chris Colabello will stand in. He flew out his last time up. And a breaking ball that's chopped foul at the plate. It's 0-1. Ball chopped foul here at the plate, and he's behind nothing and two. He waits. Now the pitch. And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2. Ball two.
Two
out with the man at first. And this is swung on and missed, though he will need to do a little housekeeping at first. And the throw is in time. It's a strikeout, and the play at first goes. David Ortiz will dig in for the third time now. He struck out and bounced out in his first two trips. Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. And he'll take this to the bag, three unassisted for the first out.
The batter, designated hitter, Travis Shaw.
Travis Shaw digs in. He was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat. And now a pitch on the way. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Bases are empty, one man out. And this is fouled back and out of play. The pitch. That misses, one and two.
Well, this is an important time for him to bear down. He's thrown the ball very well, but he doesn't want to let the meat of this order ruin what he's done so far.
And he lays off it to even the count, two and two.
He's hoping to just run that heater by him. So he's ramped up the velocity here in the last two pitches.
And he is on strikes again. So get your hats out. That's the third strikeout of the game.
Well, the strikeout pitch has certainly been there for him all afternoon. And this, in fact, is the third time he's victimized this guy.
Pablo Sandoval will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. You have to say, they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan has been the execution of that game plan.
Okay.
You're exactly right. They've held this lineup at bay.
And he's got another one. 13 strikeouts now, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Red Sox. They still find themselves down 6-0. Russell Martin will stand in here hoping to duplicate what he did back in the second inning as we flash you back to take another look at his solo home run that helped get this offense rolling. Here's the pitch. High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one.
Yeah, he's not really getting on top of that curveball right now. That's going to get him into trouble if he keeps leaving it up there like that.
Here it comes. And the 1-0 is sent out to straightaway center field. Bradley has a beat on this one, and he's got it for out number one. Darwin Barney stands into the box. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. Now here it comes. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball here, 0-1. And I'm not sure, but it looks like he may have been blindfolded for that swing. It's 0-2 now.
Oh, this is exactly where you want that changeup to be. That thing fell right through the bottom of the zone. No chance.
Tried to stay back on the changeup there, but this is chopped foul at home plate. The 0-2 once more. Swinging a ball hit softly on the ground. But a foul ball, and the count holds at 0-2. And he got him.
And that That's what's known as jelly legging a hitter up there. I mean, watch that front leg just sort of flinches. At first, he's thinking he's got to get out of the way of this thing. But as it turns out, it comes right back over the inside corner.
Swing and a miss on a pitch in the dirt, and it's strike one.
And for as bad as he missed that pitch, you can bet we're going to see that again before this at-bat's over.
And he gets him to lift one high in the air and drifting out to shallow center. And Pedroia will make the catch, and the inning is over. Blue Jays go down in order. They lead it 6-0. Dustin Pedroia will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there. And he's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
No, he's been dominant all game long. And I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on. And that's allowed him to not really worry about making a mistake. He's been free and easy the whole way through.
Now here's the pitch. And this will be fouled away. Now here's the pitch. And here's one that misses to Pedroia, and the count evens at 1-1. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And taken in out there for the first out.
Number 25, center fielder, Jackie Bradley Jr.
Jackie Bradley Jr., ready to try again, struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. And now a pitch on the way. Out in front as he lifts a fly ball out toward right field. There to take it is Bautista, and he's got it for out number two.
Now batting, left fielder,
Ruzne Castillo will stand in now with two away, needing to really get something started here.
And their chances of getting back into this ballgame are growing dimmer by the batter.
He swings and pops it high in the air out towards shallow right. Barney is there, and it's a very quick inning as the side is retired. Red Sox go down 1-2-3. They won't make a dent in a 6-0 deficit. Troy Tulowitzki will stand in now to lead things off, and he'll do so with the same pitcher still out there. Seems he's earned himself another inning.
I think that's a definite vote of confidence, but he's done a nice job since coming in, so you might as well ride that hot hand.
And this one misses to Tulowitzki. It's a ball and a strike. Fouled back. And the pitch. And he struck him out. And there's the hat trick, as that's his third strikeout of the ballgame. Kevin Pillar steps in and perhaps looking to drive another one out of the park, just like he did in the second. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. And that jammed him a bit there as it's fouled at the plate. Now the pitch. Pitch in the dirt is swung on and missed, so he'll need to get the force at first. Throw to first will take care of him. Score it 2-3 on the putout, and there are two gone now.
Yeah, a nice job behind the plate. He wants it low, so he's got a good idea that this ball might be in the dirt, so he's able to smother it and then make the strong throw to first.
Standing in now, Josh Donaldson, as he'll take a look at a high strike that time. It's nothing and one.
Another good job of getting ahead here. He just seems so locked in right now.
Two out, nobody on. Now a ground ball hit sharply back up the box, and it'll get into center field, a two-out single.
And at this point, I don't think you could expect anything less than a two-hit ball game from this guy. I mean, he's been as hot as anybody lately, and he comes through again here.
Jose Bautista
stands in. He'll try to improve in this at-bat after grounding into a fielder's choice his last time up. He's set. Now the pitch. This is hit down the right field line, but it's going to get out of play for strike one. Strike two. Pitch in the dirt, swung on and missed for strike three as they'll need to throw to first here. And the throw to first will indeed get him. It's a strikeout, score at 2-3, and the inning is over. One left for Toronto, but they're on top by a count of 6-0. Blake Swihart, ready to take another shot, went down on strikes his last time up.
For the Red Sox, catcher, number 23.
First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one.
And right now, these guys just need something to break their way. A blooper, a bunt, a hit by pitch, something to get a base runner and give that guy something else to think about out there.
And this is fouled back and out of play. Here's the pitch. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. Count holds at 1-2. Here it comes. Now another pitch is hit foul and headed for the seats, so the count will stay put at 1-2. And that's going to land foul. To two balls and two strikes now.
2-2.
And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2.
Oh, I think he'd be real happy with a leadoff walk. Something just to get things started against this guy.
And he's just going to make him throw as many pitches as he can as he fouls another one away, and it's still folded 3-2. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. Struck him out and make it 14 punch-outs now in the game.
Well, we've talked about it already, but this has just been an absolutely dominating performance out there. That's 14 strikeouts.
Stepping in now, Mookie Betts. As he swings and pops this one foul off to the right, out of play. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out.
Yeah, a good pitch there as he gets the pop out on the fastball as we take a look at his pitch breakdown so far.
Xander Bogaerts will stand in now as their last shot here with two away in the ninth.
Yeah, just one final hurdle here before he finishes off the shutout.
Now here it comes. And a called strike down in the zone, nothing and one. And this one's downstairs. It's a ball and a strike. Now the pitch. And this is chopped foul near the plate, and the count will move to 1-2 now. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. There to field it is Tulowitzki. Throw on to first is going to be in time, and the Blue Jays will add one more to their winning streak as this ball game is over.
Yeah, just two hits were all they could muster off of him. He was in complete control from the start of this game, and he finished it off in style, too.
One more look at the final line score there to see the great pitching performance that led his guys to the victory. And guys, you can't win if you can't score, so there's probably not a whole lot of debate about who'll take home Topps Player of the Game honors in this one.
Yeah, really a dominating performance out there. Look at all the strikeouts. I mean, they just couldn't touch him.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Caro, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com. The Blue Jays come out on top, 6-0. So long from Fenway.
Fans, our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Blue Jays, 6 runs. 11 hits, no errors, left 7 men on base. For the Red Sox, no runs and only 2 hits. 1 error, they left 2 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 55 minutes. A reminder that extra Green Line trains will be available at the Kenmore stop. Or if you plan to use the D-Branch, use the Fenway stop. Rail service is available at the Yawkey Station, located on Brookline Avenue, within walking distance of Fenway Park.